Hello there. I'm Hayden from Wix Stores, and I'm going to describe in this talk how in Wix Stores we integrated with Avalara tax calculations. What is Wix e-commerce? Well, as some of you may know, Wix is a platform for building your own websites, and as part of that platform, there are full e-commerce capabilities where, as a merchant, you can create your own online store. You can design the online store that you've always wanted. It's a complete e-commerce solution from a full-fledged storefront, full capabilities for configuring the store, including shipping, fulfillment, coupons, and last but not least, tax. And we do pride ourselves on being a do-it-yourself platform, which means we try to make it as easy as possible for business owners, site owners, and the merchants themselves. They don't need to be too technological in order to get their website up and running. In the beginning, we thought that we knew everything we needed to about sales tax. But very quickly, we realized when we went live with sales tax and we got a lot of customer requests, we realized that it's a much more complex monster than we thought it was, and we realized we needed to integrate with a company that knows what they're doing. They know how to calculate sales tax and VAT, which is why we started to partner with Avalara. And in this talk, I'm going to do a demo about Wix Stores, especially around the tax configuration and how we calculate sales tax. Once we finish the demo, we're going to take a look under the hood with some deep dive into the architecture, how we build the system, the APIs we called in Avalara. After that, I'm going to describe some of the challenges we had with integration with Avalara. And after that, we will have some time for some questions. So let's get to know Wix Stores. And we're going to do a live demo now where I'm going to show how we onboard tax when we onboard with Avalara and we use that newly created account. Okay, so what we see here is our business manager of Wix for our online store, and we're focusing on the tax configuration. This is the area where our merchants will configure where they're collecting their tax, how they want to display their tax. Do they want to add tax at checkout, or is tax already included in the price? In addition, in the Wix editor, we can configure how tax is being displayed in the shopping cart. Are we displaying tax or not displaying tax at the cart stage? And most importantly, what we can see here, we have manual rates here. But I'm going to now demonstrate how we can onboard a new how we can onboard this new store onto Avalara. So I'm going to enter my details here. Okay, I'm putting in my address. This is going to be the address which is registered for the newly created Avalara account. Okay. This is not a real zip code in the UK, but no matter, this should still work. And what's happening now is our super Wix user in Avalara is actually creating an account on behalf of the merchant. So this account has been created, and it's actually also added a default tax region for us in Avalara. And if we just take a look here, I'm going to now log into Avalara with a newly created account. Okay, so it's now logging in, and we'll be able to view the nexuses that have been created. So if you remember, we had France, Israel, Italy, and the UK. And now we're going to look at the nexuses that we actually have now for this account. And as you can see here, we have nexuses for Israel, Italy, and the United Kingdom. And now we can now finalize the configuration for this store by assigning products to tax groups. Now in Wix stores, we have tax groups which are light wrappers over Avalara tax codes, where we can assign products in the store's catalog to different tax codes. For example, we have a clothing store here. Some of the items are children's clothing and some of them are adults' clothing. Children's clothing, for example, in the UK is not taxed. And we've assigned it to this tax code for children's clothing. And we actually already have assigned one product to the children's clothing, which is a boys t-shirt. We're now going to actually assign another product, which is a girl's party dress, onto the tax group, and we can save. Okay, so if we now go to the store, we can actually see that we have those items here in the store. We have children's clothing, we have some adults' clothing. So I'm going to add both the girls' party dress and the boys' t-shirt over to my shopping cart. And let's view the cart and let's configure it to be shipping in the United Kingdom. And we can see that we actually are not being charged tax at all for this purchase. Let's go now and shop for a men's shirt. And now look at our cart and see if anything has been changed. So now we see that our £30 men's shirt is being charged at 20%, which is why we have the estimated tax at 6. So this is taking into consideration the tax groups we assigned in the business manager. Now let's do a checkout. When we're checking out, I will now demonstrate that after having paid for the product, we then commit the transaction to Avalara, so this transaction and this order can be used for reporting to the tax authorities. So I'm now going to place this order. Okay, the order has been placed and created. It has not been paid for because it was using manual payment methods. So I'm now going to mark this new order as paid over here. And now what I'm going to do is actually going to head to the transactions page and hopefully we will see this new transaction that's been registered within Wix. Okay, we see here we have order number 10005, which was just created on the 17th. If we click into here, we can actually see the details of the order, which is those three items which are added together with free shipping. And we see the tax details here. Okay, but that's not always, things don't always end with a happy ending. Sometimes we need to process refunds. So let's have a look, actually have a look what happens when a refund is requested. So let's say the customer is unhappy with the order and we want to issue a refund of £35, and here we're, because we haven't sent the product, we're actually cancelling the order. And if we now jump back into Avalara and view the transactions, we're now going to see a specific transaction which is representing that refund. So the report that we are creating in Avalara is reflecting 100% what financial transactions have been happening. We received an order for £70, but at the end we did a refund for £35. This is all being managed automatically, and the merchant doesn't need to go into Avalara and mess around with the transactions that have already been created. Okay, so now let's take a look under the hood. We're going to sort of see how we built this system from a very high level. So taking a look at the tax calculation, we both have the cart and the checkout that are calling via our GraphQL protocol out to the cart service, where we are adding the cart items, calculating shipping, coupons, and finally, the tax calculation. And on a high level, we have quite a few services which are calling out to the tax service on, as well as the dashboard, sorry, as well as the card and checkout. First of all is a dashboard service, a business manager, which is doing the onboarding, adding and removing nexuses. We have the card and checkout. When an order is being processed, we commit the transaction to the tax service where we create a transaction within Avalara. And we also have back office service where there are certain endpoints that we call, which show us some diagnostics and some calls within Avalara to help our support engineers. The onboarding process, as we saw, the onboarding can take up to 15 seconds. So we actually process these requests asynchronously. We put them into a queue, and then we have workers which take those requests off the queue and issue a request new account call to Avalara, where on behalf of our merchant, we are creating a new account. This account gets saved in Avalara. After that, we then make a call and query for the default company that's being created, and we also save that company ID within our system as well. And after that, we also create a default tax region and nexus for that newly created account as well. When we add or even remove a tax region, it's not just adding it in our own system now. We need to call out to Avalara and create a nexus. Before we create a nexus, we need to actually retrieve the nexus definitions from Avalara via the list nexus endpoint. And once we've called that, we actually call out to the company nexus endpoint, and the nexus is created or removed in Avalara. When we have, if the user moves to the manual calculator and they have been managing their tax regions, adding and removing, and then they subsequently want to re-enable Avalara, we need to make sure that the nexus in Avalara reflects the tax regions that they have configured within Wix to make sure there's no misunderstandings and complete synchronicity between Wix and Avalara. So we actually read the list of tax regions which have been which exist in Avalara. We look at what we currently have, and then if there's a difference, we create any missing nexuses and we delete any extra nexuses in Avalara. For the tax calculations, we take our cart, and then we actually we call out to the create transaction method in Avalara, where we because we've already created the nexuses, we get the tax calculation, and then we return that to our user. We first of all check that a tax region has been configured. We don't want to call out if there's no reason to. So we first check that we've configured that tax region within our business manager, and only then do we actually make the call out. But the tax calculation can fail for reasons of connection issues, or if there's inconsistency between the zip code and the US state, for example, where Avalara would return an error. We do not want to fail the request in that case. So we have a fallback tax service, which gives us those manual rates we saw before in the live demo. So people can always add things to their cart, get tax calculations, and continue to the checkout. After a order has been created, we then want to commit that transaction to Avalara, which we do asynchronously. With a create transaction with a sales invoice flag, and that gets saved to Avalara. In a very similar way, when processing refunds, we also asynchronously process those refunds. We call out to our tax service where we create a refund invoice transaction in Avalara, which is also what we saw in the live demo. Now I'm gonna talk a few minutes about the challenges that we've had. And I'm going to start off talking about the challenge we had with transparent administration of the Avalara account. So we want to keep things easy for our users, but we put a lot of the difficulty on ourselves, where we had the challenge of doing the whole onboarding process, which I described, requesting a new account, querying the company, creating a new nexus, adding and removing nexuses. It's a very complex scenario with quite tricky APIs, which took us quite a while to get the hang of. And the operations of our system is also challenging. We're not located in the same data center as Avalara. So in order to reduce latency, we implemented a cache where if the same call for the same cart with the same configuration is issued within a certain time window, then we store that in a cache. In addition, for resilience, as I mentioned, we created a whole backup calculator where to allow our users to always be able to complete their transaction. Consistency is tricky. We have multiple systems, such as invoices, internal and external invoicing systems. We need to make sure that the way they round tax rates and tax amounts is the same way that we round them and we display them. Otherwise, we get some customer complaints, which we found quite tricky. And we pride ourselves in Wix with our practice of test-driven development, which means we don't write any code without any test to back it up. And this is tricky when it's a third-party API, an external API, where we need to simulate the responses, whether they're success or they're failure, and also implementing full complex scenarios can also be extremely challenging as well, from configuring the tax system, onboarding, cart checkout and refunds, and making sure transactions are saved in Avalara is a big challenge. Lots and lots of automated tests. And where do we plan on going from here? So we have requests where some of our users would like to attach the same Wix store to the same Avalara account, or they might have a pre-existing Avalara account from an external system that they want to connect into. We want to create more transparency and visibility for both our merchants and also for our support teams of how tax was being calculated. So that brings us to an end of my talk. I hope you found it useful and interesting. And now we have time for some questions.